So you've probably heard of Lyme disease, maybe even West Nile or Zika, but have you heard of Chagas disease? Well, here's why you should. Although Chagas disease has long been considered a tropical illness, it's actually increasingly being found right here in the United States. I'm Dr. Dray, I'm a board-certified dermatologist, and today we're gonna talk about the skin signs, the symptoms, and the silent risks of Chagas disease, including why it matters now more than ever. So Chagas disease is caused by a parasite called Trypanosoma cruzi. It's actually spread by an insect named the kissing bug or the reduvid bug. It's been labeled as non-endemic in the United States for decades, but the label no longer reflects reality. So the bugs that carry the parasite are actually common in southern states, and there have been already local human cases reported in at least 8 U.S. states, especially right here in Texas where I live. So that's why recognizing the signs, including how it shows up on the skin, could help catch the disease early and prevent long-term damage. And a big theme on my channel, you guys who watch, you already know, the skin, it is a window to what is going on internally. And wouldn't you love to catch a parasitic disease in its tracks because you are aware of the skin signs? Well, this is the video to educate yourself. What exactly is Chagas disease? Chagas disease is an infection. It's caused by the Trypanosoma cruzi parasite, and it spreads most commonly through the bite of an infected kissing bug, also called a triatomine bug. Now, these bugs, they bite around the face or around your mouth while you're sleeping. Yikes! The parasite doesn't come from the bite itself, however, but from, get this, the bug's feces. Yeah, you guessed it. If you get that rubbed into your eyes, your mouth, or broken skin, then you can get infected with the parasite. So for years, this disease was thought to be limited to Central and South America, but we know now that's no longer true. Multiple species of the triatomine bug are actually found across the southern United States. They can invade homes, infect domestic animals like your dogs, and they carry the same parasites. Wildlife, pets, even captive animals are reservoirs, so they help the disease spread unnoticed. And humans here in the United States, they're getting infected even without traveling internationally to areas that historically have been endemic of Chagas disease. So that means it's present, but it's under-recognized. So considering it or labeling it non-endemic just sort of perpetuates low awareness and under-reporting, which unfortunately leads to misdiagnoses. So Chagas disease actually has two main phases, an acute phase and a chronic phase. In the acute phase, which is usually within the first few weeks of infection, that's when most people might develop some symptoms, which include fatigue, fever, body aches, swollen glands, sometimes diarrhea and vomiting. But here's the tricky part. A lot of people, they don't even feel ill. And if they do, they just kind of have like what feels like a mild viral infection. But then the disease can enter a long silent phase, which sometimes lasts years or even decades. And this is called the chronic phase. During this time, most people have no clue they're even infected. But about 20 to 30% will actually go on to develop serious heart problems as a result of the infection. These include arrhythmias, heart failure, even cardiomyopathy. Some will also go on to develop other health problems like digestive issues, swollen esophagus or colon. That's called mega esophagus and mega colon. Now let's focus on where I come in, and that is as a dermatologist. We're going to talk about the skin warning signs. So one of the most important and visible early signs of Chagas disease is found, on the skin. Dermatologists can actually make the diagnosis and really help change the trajectory of that patient's disease course for the better by identifying it early. So the most classic skin finding is called the chagoma. It's a red, swollen lump, usually at the site where the parasite entered. It's often firm, tender. It doesn't go away quickly. Another warning sign is called Romaña sign. This usually shows up as a painless swelling of one eyelid, often with redness. And this happens when the parasite has entered through the eye. So if the bug bit you on your face and then it defecated and you rubbed it into your eye, that could lead to Romaña sign. And it can kind of look like an allergic reaction, an insect bite, or even pink eye, but it's actually something much more serious. In some people, especially young children, you can get what looks like a measles type rash. And the name of the rash is called schizotrypanitis. It usually shows up in the acute phases of the illness, kind of a non-specific rash. Now, for patients who are immunocompromised, like those with HIV or those who have had an organ transplant, Chagas disease can actually reactivate, wake back up and cause really painful nodules, raised areas of the skin, rashes that look like other skin conditions. These skin clues may be the first and only sign that something is wrong. So if you or someone you know develops unexplained swelling, lumps, or rashes, especially with bug exposures, don't ignore it. See a board certified dermatologist. I want to draw your attention to some particularly high risk groups when it comes to talking about Chagas disease. Some people are at much higher risk for serious complications from this infection. Babies can actually be born with Chagas disease if their mother is infected. This is known as congenital Chagas disease. Symptoms in a newborn baby could include a rash, swelling, low birth weight, even liver or spleen enlargement. Then there are people who have a weakened immune system. They're a lot more vulnerable to severe disease or reactivation of the disease. So if you are a pet owner, especially a pet owner living in the southern United States, you should know that dogs are commonly infected and they could actually bring these bugs inside. How is this diagnosed and when should you see a doctor? Well, if you've had possible exposure and you're experiencing unusual symptoms like swelling near the eye, a lump that doesn't go away, fatigue, a new rash, then it's definitely time to get in to see a healthcare provider to talk to your doctor. Testing might be performed, like a blood smear to look for early infection, certain antibody tests, and importantly, your dermatologist likely will perform a biopsy if you have a skin lesion like a chagoma. I'm telling you, early diagnosis makes a huge difference. Like most illnesses, treatment works best when initiated early on. Even better than treatment, though, is preventing it. So what can be done to prevent this? If you live in the southern United States, seal up any cracks and gaps in your homes that bugs could get in. Use window screens, bed netting if necessary. Clean up around your home. Kissing bugs like to hide in wood piles, brush, and animal kennels. How is this treated? Treatment includes antiparasitic medications like benzinidazole and nifurtimox. These can stop the parasites, but again, they work best when started early. For those who have chronic disease, treatment can reduce the symptoms and slow the progression. And of course, those patients might need supportive care from cardiology or gastroenterology in terms of addressing some of the complications like heart disease and diseases of the digestive tract. So, what are the big takeaway points from this video? It's certainly not intended to scare you, but rather to inform you because knowledge is power, right? Chagas disease isn't solely a problem that one might encounter outside of the United States. It's likely under-recognized and endemic in parts of the United States. Skin signs like a chagoma or swelling around the eye can be the first clue. Early diagnosis can save lives. So if you have lived in or have traveled to southern states and have any of the symptoms we talked about, please see your healthcare provider or a dermatologist, or if necessary, they can refer you to a dermatologist. See, you guys thought all we did was Botox, filler, and pimples, but we're saving lives out here one kissing bug at a time. All right, y'all, I really hope this video was informative, educational, you learned something. If you guys liked it, guess what? I have a whole playlist of skin signs of various medical illnesses, various infections like tuberculosis, shingles, measles, and syphilis. All those things that you thought were from a time long, long ago that continue to appear and affect people. Yeah, we've got videos on the skin warning signs of those. So definitely check those out. I'll link the playlist in the description box. But if you like this one, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends. And as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.